Before I begin, I just want to see a quick show of hands. Did you have a bad customer experience lately? I did. Anybody else? I see a few hands go up. Don't be shy. Great. What happened is I went to this store. I go pretty often. It's a chain. And I'm a regular customer, loyal customer there. I have a lot of points. There was an issue with, we bought it in my wife's name, and it was a big purchase, so we wanted to make sure that everything is kind of accounted for. So we wanted to see if we can do something about it, transfer the points. It's where it all started. I called them, I went to the store, they asked me to go to a website, fill a form. I did that, I got a call back. The person had no clue why I had filled the web form. I had to again call multiple people. It went on for 3 months. I had spoken to 6 customer support agents, and I had spent 8 hours of my life trying to sort this mess out. I'm Narayan. I am from FreshWorks. I head marketing for Asia, India, and Asia. So more on me later. This is the company I work for. Again, more on this later. We have 175 customers across the globe. Some of our happy customers, and some of our investors. So let's get back to the problem we have at hand. I wanted to see if we can transfer points to my wife's name. They were OK with it, but the process was messed up. I spoke to around 6 agents from the customer support team. I had to walk to the store multiple times. I spent 3 months of my, 8 hours of my life trying to figure things out to get things done. So what went wrong in my experience, right? So this is what we like to call the assembly line model of customer support. I was passed on from person to person, from team to team, from agent to agent. And there was no real, you know, collaboration happening. And there was touchpoint amnesia. I would call support line. I would explain my ordeal, my story to them. I would call them again, and they would ask me what my issue was. And I would have to start right from the beginning. People I spoke to really had zero context about me or my issue at hand. So I had to explain the same thing over and over again. They had no clue which store I had gone to. They had no clue what my purchase value was. They had no clue whom I had spoken to before. And there was absolutely zero collaboration happening within the team. Nobody knew what the other person was working on, and I was really caught in the mess. And finally, I was trapped in a ticket. To them, I was a ticket ID. To them, I was not a customer. I was not a human being. I was a ticket number. They would ask me, sir, what is your ticket ID? And it was really demeaning after a point. So I would like to boldly make a statement that the current customer support model is broken. So let's fix it, shall we? So what is good customer experience? I would say, to get a customer with a problem to become a happy customer, we need automated answers. For example, when the person comes to a website, your website, you want to make sure that he's able to talk to chatbots to automate the process. You want to give him answers. If it doesn't solve it, you want to send him or her to the right customer support agent. And you have to give the agent enough context. And you have to make sure that the agent has enough knowledge solve the issue, right? I think this is the very, I think we all can kind of relate to this. Now, let's dismantle the assembly line that I spoke about earlier. So what should the new customer support model look like? So we all have seen Formula One races where the racer comes to the pit lane, into the pit stop, and suddenly around 10 engineers kind of converge on the car, and each person knows what to do. Each person has a role to play, and they all do it in a fraction of a second, right? So the pit stop model of customer support should look like this. The customer comes in with an issue. Each of us knows exactly what our role is, what to do. So we spoke about how to take a customer with an issue to a happy customer. And now let's talk about how to take a happy customer to a customer who says, wow. So less hands off. We don't want customer support agents to hand off to another agent. We want to maintain transparency. I think the best rule of customer support is to communicate, even if it's bad news. And customize your approach. The person talking to you has a name, right? It's not a customer ID, it's a human being. And finally, offer proactive support. Today, customers want to know about an issue when it is about to happen, not after, but before. Offer proactive customer support. So is the pit stop model viable? I say yes, and that's where we use technology to kind of help you offer pit stop model of customer support. We have big data, we have data, right? We know about our customers better than they know themselves. Big data can feed into machine learning. The machine learns, which feeds into chatbots, for example. And chatbots can offer natural language processing based support. So for example, somebody would ask you, which is the best store for me to pick up summer clothes, right? Now, the system has to understand this in natural language, process it, and then throw answer back in natural language. And that's collaboration finally. So I repeat, big data feeds into machine learning, which feeds into bots, natural language processing, and there's collaboration. So just to summarize the pit stop model, focus on people, right? In fact, I had a very good friend of mine tell me a few days back, that back in the days, project management was all about people, product, project, and process. But today, it's all about people. The four P's is people. You don't talk to customers, you don't talk to customer IDs, you talk to human beings. Focus on relationships. And finally, build a customer-centric culture within the company, within the team. Oops, is that an empty slide? Yeah, that seems to be an empty slide. So what do we do now? Okay, can you just please stand up for a second, please? Thank you. Now, I'm going to count to three, or rather I can say, yeah, 1, 2, 3, and I want you guys to jump at the count of three. Shall we do it? Can I have a yes? Thank you. 1, 2, and 3. Amazing. Thank you. Please sit down. You guys are a sport. Thank you. So, thank you, guys. So, when we speak to our prospects or customers and tell them that you got to implement the pit stop model of customer support. You know what they tell us? They say, you know what? It's not possible. It's not practical. We have other things to manage. We are fighting fire every day. We are firefighting. It's really not possible for us to go back to the team and say, you know, pit stop model, blah, blah, blah. But what just happened? Now, if somebody had told you this morning when you got up from your bed that today this madrasi will come on stage and make you guys jump, you would have said, no, it's impossible, not practical. But what happened, right? So please go back to teams and tell them that the pit stop model is viable and you have to implement it in order to kind of stand out amongst your competition. So I will let you guys, I will leave this image here. Pit stop model can make your customers look like this. We are Freshworks, and I would like to summarize my talk by saying customer support is everybody's business. If you guys want to chat up with us about what I spoke about, NLP, big data, chatbots, We have a booth right here in Hall Z. We would love to chat up with you. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's put our hands together for Sathyanarain, Muralidharan.